Hi, I'm Massimiliano Marcon, and I'm the product manager for developer tools at MongoDB. Today, I'm really excited to show you MongoDB for VS Code. So VS Code is the most popular code editor, and its extensibility makes it possible to customize the coding experience and tailor it to the language, frameworks, and services developers use to build applications. To make developers more productive when working with MongoDB, we built MongoDB for VS Code, an extension that allows you to quickly connect to MongoDB and Atlas and to work with your data to build applications right inside your code editor. Let me give you a tour of the extension. So the first thing we're going to do is to connect to MongoDB. And the easiest way to do that is through the command palette with a connection string. So with this connection string, I'm going to connect to my Atlas cluster. And you can see here that I'm connected now. So I've shown you how to connect with the connection string, but sometimes you have more advanced connection configuration, and we support that too. We have a form where you can specify hostname and port, of course, but also advanced authentication options. You can specify your read preferences and your SSL and SSH tunnel options. Let's explore the extensions a bit more. So let me look at this connection that I already have here. As you can see, when I unfold the connection in the tree view, I see all my databases. I can pick a database, for instance, the sample Airbnb, and I can see the collections inside the database. And for every collection, I can take a look at the documents. These are very big documents. And I also have a quick overview of the schema. This is extremely useful when I'm writing queries, because then I know what fields I can add to my queries. I also know what type those fields are. So I have numbers, I have strings, I have dates. And sometimes the type is unknown, and we let you know about that too. So you have to be a bit more careful when you query, or maybe tweak your data insertion to make sure that type is what you expect. The next thing I want to show you is playgrounds. So playgrounds are JavaScript environments where you can type any MongoDB command, or you can play around with queries and aggregations. And the nice thing about playground is that you get syntax highlighting, so you know if you're typing the right thing. And this applies both to JavaScript as well as to MongoDB operators and expressions. And you get intelligent autocomplete, which is really useful because it saves you a lot of typing and, of course, a lot of time. For example, in this case, if I do db.sales, it knows that the sales collection is inside this database here and autocompletes it for me. And then I get autocomplete for MongoDB commands. And it doesn't stop there, because at this point, I even get autocomplete for fields. So again, I'm saving a lot of typing and I get things done quickly. Now, this playground I can run immediately and get the results down here. This is really great because it helps me iterate over queries, aggregations, commands, and get the results immediately, know what I'm doing, and potentially copy paste this code somewhere else. Now, playgrounds can also be used as a quick way to seed a database with test data. And this is really useful in the context of working with a team. So you can design your schema. You can define a few test documents or write a script that generates them in a MongoDB playground. Save your playground file and check it into your code repository so everybody in your team is aligned on what the data looks like and can quickly generate test data in their test cluster. Let's see how that can work. So this we don't need. So let's say I am a new member of this team and I check out this repository, and we're building this application where we want to display some insights from Fitbit step counting data. And I see here that there's a to-do for me. I need to add an aggregation to calculate average steps on weekdays. Cool. Now, I need to figure out what the data looks like. And I see that here I have a CDB playground. So I'm going to take a look at that. So this selects a database, Fitbit. Then it cleans up potentially all data. Then it does a bulk insert of all the documents that I have specified here. This is great. it does some cleanup of the data, converting dates to dates and numbers to numbers. That's cool. And then it creates indexes, which is cool because this is what I need for my query probably. So you can see it's not just queries and aggregations. You can add any MongoDB command to a playground. And in this case, it's creating indexes. And then at the end, it prints out the results. Let's try to run this. Cool. So it tells me that 29 documents were inserted in the collection. And this looks about right. And then that there are three indexes for the collection, which makes sense because two I created myself. And one is the underscore ID that is always present in MongoDB. Great. So now let's go back to the application. So I need to create this aggregation. The best way to do that is with a playground. And I actually prepared a template that we can get started with. Because VS Code supports side-by-side editing, I can actually do this so I can keep my application next to my playground. So as I iterate over things, I can potentially copy-paste things back and forth. So let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is, of course, match for that user ID, because that's what my function here says. So this is not for everybody. This is specific to a user ID. So what I'm going to do is create a stage, match user. Every good aggregation starts with a match. So we match and we say, let's see, my Fitbit data has been added. So user ID, cool. So then user ID equals my example user ID that I have up here. Then in the function, it will take the right one. And then the second thing I'm going to do is to add a field. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I need to only provide average steps for weekdays. So I need to know what a weekday is. So let's do add fields. And we do day of the week. This is what we're going to call it. And MongoDB then has a handy function to do exactly that. Day of week. And you see how syntax highlighting is useful because as soon as I've typed the right expression, then it gets highlighted. And I want the day of week for the date field. It's nice that I have the schema always here on the side because I can always reference it when I'm building my queries. And now we can start putting these stages in. I like to break down my aggregation into stages in this way because then I can run them and enable, disable different stages. It's a very nice way of doing it. Cool. So then we see that the field has been added. Now, the next thing we're going to do is to filter only weekdays. So we do another match operation for weekdays. And the way that works is, so day of week returns a number between 1 and 7, where 1 is Sunday and 7 is Saturday. So we're going to filter for everything in between. And to make it a bit faster, I actually have that in my clipboard. There it is. So as you can see, now we are matching for anything that is greater than 1 or less than 7. And then we can add this here as well. And it's cool because as you can see, I can keep iterating over and over until I find what I need. I think now I have the right data. I just need to average it. So what I'm going to do is to add a group stage where I do $group and my ID in this case can be null. And we're going to call this average steps. My accumulator is going to be an average because that's exactly what I need. And I'm going to average, I would say steps. Very good. Now let's add it here. And as you can see, this is exactly what I wanted. Now that underscore ID, I don't really need, so I can quickly add an unset stage to get rid of it. There you go. And this should do exactly what we need. Perfect. So this is the aggregation I was looking for. And now what's nice is that I can just select it, copy it, put it inside my code. And if I've done everything right, I can now run my Fitbit.js application with Node. And I'm going to pass the user ID to it. So it should only filter for those steps. There you go. So as expected, I can see now the very same result I had in the playground. And this is great. So what have we seen? Playgrounds are a useful way to get developers started quickly by providing files they can look at and quickly run to seed their database for testing. We've also seen how playgrounds are convenient to prototype queries and aggregations and can be used side by side with your application during development. So now the VS Code extension that we built has a nice set of functionality, but sometimes you need to go a bit beyond what we can provide in a user interface. Maybe you need to run an admin command, or you need to inspect the status of your cluster. So in this case, we thought it would be nice to be able to launch a MongoDB shell connected exactly to the same cluster you have active in your sidebar. And there you go. So just a keyboard shortcut away, you can launch a shell. And if we check now, those are exactly the same DBs that we see here in the list. So this is great. Last thing I want to show you is less about working with the data in your database and more about managing your infrastructure. So if you manage your infrastructure with Terraform, the MongoDB Atlas Terraform provider is a great way to set up and configure your Atlas resources. If you are not familiar with it, I suggest you check it out. And in MongoDB for VS Code, we've added a snippet that helps you bootstrap your Terraform configuration for Atlas. So let's say we are inside a Terraform file. What you need to do is just to type Atlas. And there you go. You have your template that you just need to fill out with the required field. It also helps you a bit when possible, sizing your cluster and deciding what region or cloud provider you want it. And then you just need to provide your API keys, your database user credentials. If you need to whitelist some IP addresses, you can put them here. And then you run this through Terraform, and immediately you get your Atlas environment bootstrapped and ready to go. So quick recap, what have we seen today? We've seen how MongoDB for VS Code makes it easy to navigate and explore your data directly inside your coding environment. We've looked at how Playground not only make a great prototyping environment to iterate over your queries and aggregations, but also are a great time saver as a way to document what your data looks like and to quickly see the test database to get developers started quickly with a new code base. We've also seen that when you're connected to a cluster, the MongoDB shell is just one keyboard shortcut away, so you can launch it quickly when you need to perform advanced operations and run admin commands. And finally, we've seen how MongoDB for VS Code is helpful when it comes to bootstrapping an Atlas cluster using Terraform. I hope you'll try out MongoDB for VS Code today, and I'm really looking forward to get your feedback.